Well, good evening. Good evening, dear residents of East Coast GRC, my brother and sisters from the NTUC and the affiliated unions. And fellow Singaporeans, are you good tonight? By the way, that was a sound test, huh? A sound test. And I hope you keep up with your volume this evening. Okay, please allow me to start with Mandarin first. 亲爱的居民们，大家晚上好。 我来了东海岸已经四年了，四年半了。过去四年半，我尽全力为您服务。举个例子，当我拜访居民的时候，我发觉到在部落，我们有很多这个年长的居民。那这年长的居民里面，有一些是单独过活，他的生活是很孤单。 有的是身体比较脆弱的年长人士，有的是残缺，有的是贫穷。整体来说，我觉得作为一个邻里，作为家园，是我们的责任，不断的去帮他们，帮他们也能够过更充实的生活，更活跃的生活。另一个就是，我发觉到。 我们的政府有很多新的政策，好的政策，可是我们居民很多都不了解，所以就举办了这个谈天说地在部落，不断的跟居民更紧密的接触。他们关心的课题，我也关心；我不懂的课题，我去学习，因为最终我要尽量的。 帮他们了解他们所关心的课题，这么的话，我相信他们就能够过更安心的生活。在过去的四年半，我在部落的那个跟居民的沟通，感觉很好，感觉很好。那么最近一个居民跟我说，他说：“林部长，你的人很好，啊，我说我的人好，我说你们的人啊更好。” 昨天晚上，有的居民说：“林部长，这次一定要赢，因为我们不能没有你。”我说：“我说你们不能没有我，我更加不能没有你。”不过我承认，我不是个完美的人。 我也有我的缺点，我也有犯我的错误。那么举个例子，虽然我的心地是善良的，可是偶尔会祸从口出。那么第一个群众大会，我提到我很庆幸我是新加坡人，嘿呀。 可是，我无意中给一些人发觉这个误解，他们以为我看不起马来西亚人，看不起中国人。我在此要重申，我绝对没有恶意，我绝对没有贬低任何其他国家的这意图。 而是我是对我是身为新加坡人而感到自豪，所以那些被我冒犯的人，我深感抱歉。这次的大选非常的激烈。 哪个政党会带领我们这国家？哪个团队会照顾东海岸基选区？到目前为止，还是一个未知数。 我没有博士的学历，我也没有牛津大学的学历。不过我有的是一颗敬爱国家、关怀人民的爱心。所以我希望大家支持我，让我继续能够关照你们、你们的家人和你们的家园。今天晚上我要跟你们分享一个我的感想。我的感想是，这个世界上的国家好多好多，可是做得好的好少啊。为什么呢？做得好的其实就两个字了，为什么做得好？那两个字是团结，团结。因为他们是个团结的国家，他们有能干、有才干的领导，所以他们想得到，所以想得到。因为他们团结，人民上下一心，互相带动，所以凡事都是事半功倍。所以他们不但只想得到，而且做得快。更重要的是，举国上下、人民政府之间互相信任，因此他们能够与时俱进，不断地适应新的环境。也就是说，不但想得到、做得快，而且变得通。要做到一个好的国家，我觉得非常重要，因为只有做得好的国家，人民才有好的生活过。很可惜的是，做得好的国家是少之又少，太少了。为什么很多国家会做不好呢？也是两个字：分裂。人民分裂，国会分裂，有些政府本身也分裂，因为它是由不同党派所组成的。在这些分裂的国家里面，大家都很忙，大家都很累，可是他们不是为他们的国民而忙，他不是为他们国家而累，他们忙和累是因为整天在搞政治，整天搞政治。那些受到人民欢迎的政策，反对党就说不够多，为什么呢？搞政治。那些不被人民欢迎的政策，他们就说太多了，少一点比较好，没有啊更好。为什么呢？搞政治。所以政治家在分裂的国家里面，政治家有的是小聪明，可是人民要付出的是大的代价。你觉得值得吗？不值得。应该吗？很可惜的是，这样的国家太多了，太多了。每届的大选都是很重要，不过这次的大选是特别的重要。为什么呢？因为这次的大选会决定我们国家未来5年的发展，而且会未来的15年定下基础，为我们未来的发展定下方向。同一个时候，培养我们第四代的领导班子。因此，我希望投票那一天，我希望我们东海岸的选民们能够冷静地投下神圣的一票。希望我们能够一起不断的团结，不断的让新加坡永远是一个为人民做得好的国家。愿望希望我们未来的50年会比过去的50年来得更好。前进吧，新加坡。Dear Dear fellow Singaporeans, over the last 9 days, you have heard many speeches. I think by now, if you are not confused, I am confused. So tonight, I like to keep my message very simple, very simple. Basically, in any election, when the voters, when you cast your votes, many of you are looking for change. Of course, right? We all want the next 5 years to be better than the last 5 years. So we are looking for change. Changes that will make our life better in the next 5 years. However, I want to share this with you. This is my observation. After 19 years in politics, is that when a political party champion any change, they may do so for at least two reasons, two different type of reasons. The first type is that they want change because they want to have good policies, better policies, to improve your life. This is one type of change. Another type of change that they are advocating is to pursue good politics to win your votes. So good policy is to improve your life. Good politics is to win your vote. So therefore, I hope when you cast your vote, think carefully. Do you want to vote for the party that pursue good policies to improve your life? Yes or no? Yeah. Or do you want to vote for the party that pursue good politics just to win your votes? Yes or no? Yeah. Let me give you some illustration rather than to just be theoretical about this. Take for example, CPF withdrawal age. You know, we have a CPF system. Took us many years to set up. In fact, many countries, they wish they have a CPF system set up 30 years or 50 years ago. Our system set up for only four purposes, very clear. That you save, your employer help you to save, government help you to save. For four purposes, housing, education, healthcare, and retirement. Only four purposes. Of the four, you can withdraw your money for education, for healthcare, for housing, as and when needed. But for retirement, obviously, right? You must try to keep it for retirement, right? Otherwise, it's not called retirement, right? So today, our CPF, the withdrawal age, is 64. So in this general election, Workers' Party say 64 too long to wait. So they propose 60. Then SDA say that 60, better than 64, still too long to wait. So they propose what? 55. So it's like doing the what? Limbo rock, is it? The lower, the better. But let me ask you, for your good, for the good of your retirement, you think that lowering this withdrawal age to 60, to 65, is it a good policy? If it's not a good policy, then why? Why do you think that Workers' Parties, SDA, why do they push for this? Exactly. Because this is good politics. What do they want? Are they worried about your retirement? So what are they worried about? Your votes. I give you another example. Foreign manpower policy. PAP governments, we give all the feedback, review our policy, DPM Taman, Finance Minister, February 2010, announced in the Parliament that we are now switching from a higher manpower growth to a lower manpower growth. And our policy intent, commitment, is to maintain the ratio of local manpower to foreign manpower to 2-to-1. So 2/3 local manpower, 1/3 foreign manpower. And along that line, we've been tightening on this growth of the foreign manpower. So take for example EP and SPAS, the drop in the growth rate in the last five years, in fact from the peak to last year, it dropped by 70%. At the same time, if you take the work permit, the EP, the SPAS all put together in the last 5 years, it dropped from a peak of 80,000 a year, the increase of 80,000 a year, to now only 30,000 a year. So this is how significant this drop is. Now, when this policy was discussed in the Parliament, tightening our foreign manpower, slowing it down, at first, Workers' Party, they say this is not good enough. Slowing down, tightening is not good enough. So what do? They push for change. They say we must freeze. Zero increase, freeze. Of course, let me ask you, if we have gone for this freezing of foreign manpower, is it a good policy? If we had listened to them, go for good politics, go for freeze, I think many SME today would have died. And many workers employed by the SME, their jobs would have died too. And we take this very seriously. Your SME accounts for 70% of the employment in Singapore. 7 out of 10 workers work in SME. Now, after 3 years of implementation, they realize that actually this tightening is already quite painful for SME. As I mentioned earlier, from 80,000 to 30,000. It's already quite painful for the SME. So now instead of admitting, no, that SME, dear SME, we Workers' Party, we were wrong. Because today you are very painful. If the government had adopted our proposal to freeze the foreign manpower today, you'll be even more painful. Right. So instead of apologizing, instead of admitting that the proposal is wrong, man, you know what they say or not? They say the reason why SME today are suffering is because of PAP. Yeah. Because PAP U-turn. Since when do we U-turn? Now, basically, it's easy for any party to go to parliament to push for good politics. Doesn't care about what the implication on the ground. Sounded very good, freezing foreign manpower. But when things turns out that they were wrong, you know what they say or not? Instead of saying that I'm wrong, they say, not me, but why tai chi. So let me ask you, is this good policy or is this good politics? PAP, we also push for change. People think that to have change, you must vote for opposition. It's not true. When you vote for PAP, you get even more changes coming your way. I give you some example. Low-wage worker. In Bedok, a few years ago, I went for house visit. I came to a house, I think it's a two-room apartment. Inside, complete darkness. So I thought nobody at home. So we knocked at the door. A lady came up. So I said, hello, Madam so-and-so. I said, how are you? She said, good. I said, oh, why is your house so dark? She said, oh, I'm trying to save energy. So why? As we went on, I discovered. She works as a cleaner in a school nearby. I won't mention the name of the school. I said, how much are you earning a month? $830. I said, is that enough? He said, not enough.
because she has to take care of her mother, who is staying with her. So, got to live in darkness, save utility. So I said, look, how about this? We have NTUC from E to I. I said, why don't? Yeah. I said, why don't you come to E to I? I said, why don't you come to E to I? I help you to get better paying job. He said, oh, Mr. Lim, thank you, but no thanks. I said, why? He said, but because the school is just nearby. Easy for me to walk to school and walk home. For two reasons. First, I save on transportation costs. But more importantly, my mother is not young anymore. So when something happens, I can rush home. So, how do we address this issue faced by the low-wage workers? One way is to implement minimum wage. Every party talk about minimum wage in this GE. It's very easy for the NTUC, for the tripartite partners to the MOM, very easy for us to just implement, just announce minimum wage. Once you announce minimum wage, then you can have the excuse. Just like in many countries, they have the excuse that, look, I'm already taking care of my low-wage workers. I've already declared a minimum wage. But we all know we're studying minimum wage for more than 20 years. In fact, NTUC even published a paper on why minimum wage is not the solution. You set the minimum wage too high, $2,000 per month. I can assure you many workers, low-wage workers, will lose their job, especially the older workers, the lower-skilled workers. If you set the minimum wage at $1,000 per month, which is what Workers' Party is proposing, in my view, it's too low. It's too low. Yeah, because once you set a minimum wage, that minimum wage very often, as seen in many countries, will become the maximum wage. Employer will say, look, I've already paid you the minimum wage, which is legal by law. Why do they pay you more? So minimum wage will become maximum wage. But most of all, look at many other countries, how often they can adjust their minimum wage upwards. Very difficult, very sticky. Yeah, because it takes a lot of effort to convince everybody. When you raise every $100, every $200, the workers or union will say, not enough. The employer said, too much. Yeah, so the government don't know what to do. So what they do? They work for general election. Yeah. Then they say, okay, move a little bit, because then keep the union happy, keep the voters happy. But you want to adjust your minimum wage once every 5 years? I think no. I don't think that solves any problem. So what do we do in Singapore? First, when you work fair income supplement, we say, look, you're low-wage workers because you put in your efforts, right? We complement your income. Now we did the WIS. Some money, cash, some go in the CPF to help to save for your retirement. So for example, somebody earning $1,000 per month can receive up to $3,500 a year in WIS, equivalent to 3.5 months of salary. So this lady, this resident I talk about, earning $830 a couple of years ago, today I'm happy to say that working in the same school, doing the same job, her salary has gone up to $1,050. $100 came from our progressive wage model, minimum wage $1,000. $50 thanks to the NWC recommendation. Yeah. So today she has $1,050 and there's still upside for her. But more importantly, PWM is not just about having a minimum wage of $1,000 for the cleaner. It's a ladder. You do indoor cleaning, starting pay 1,000. Outdoor cleaning, 1,002. Machine operators, 1,004. A team leader, a supervisor, 1,006. This is the reason why we don't go for minimum wage. We go for progressive wage. Why? Why? Because low wage workers deserve to have wage progression as well, just like you and I. The same is not happening to the security sector. The tripartite works together, they reach agreement. So the security sector next year will come on a progressive wage. Same thing applied to landscaping. Now, another example. So to me, is this a good policy or not? Progressive wage. Another example I share with you is water supply. Water supply. An old way of water supply, to increase water supply. Let's say you have one drop of water today. And in the future, you need to have four drops. From one drop to four drops. How to get from one drop to four drops? This is a kindergarten school examination question. Yeah. Why? From one to get to four, very simple. One plus three equal to four. Your pass. So there is an old way. Except that in the case of water supply, the plus three will come from what? Come from desalination, turning seawater to plain water. Very expensive because of salt content in the seawater. So we crack. PAP governments, push or change. One plus three equal to four is not viable, not sustainable. So we went for change. What did we do? We changed the one plus three equal to four to a different formula. One plus one equal to how much? How many? Two. Two times two? See? One plus three equal to four. But one plus one multiplied by two also equals to four. The plus one, desalination water. Very expensive. The times two? New water! Yeah. Every drop of water uses two times. Yeah, that's how we solve problems that other countries could not solve. Is it change good policy or not? Yeah. Women. Very often women have to choose between family and career. And we are trying very hard, tripartite partners, to help to support the women so that they don't have to. They can have both family and career. And to do so, we need to have support from firstly the family. The husband. Husband cannot play golf on Sunday, right? So stay at home, take care, support the wife. Secondly, the employers must introduce flexible wage arrangement. Flexi workload, flexi hour, flexi location. Thirdly, community must play a part too. For example, provide good health childcare facility in the community. Make it easier for the young parents. Last but not least, government. We must play a part too. So for example, our marriage and parenthood packages, for example. Because of all these efforts put in by the family, by the community, by the employer and the government, here in Singapore, in the last 5 years, from 2009 to 2014, the number of female in employment went up from 800,000 to 940,000, an increase of 140,000 in 5 years. Let me ask you, is that good policy? In this general election, worker parties came up. They said, the best way, or one best way to grow our workforce is to get more women to come back to work. So when I hear that, I said, it is a good idea, except that they are at least 5 years too late. Lah. But why do they say that? I'm very sure they know that we've been promoting this back to work women for many years. Why is it they wait until now to talk about this? Why? Good politics. Mature workers, retirement age, is always very sticky in any country. Same for Singapore. So we try to raise the retirement age from 62 to a higher age. Couldn't get it going. Union pushed very hard. Employer resisted very hard. Deadlock. We couldn't solve it. So it happened that one year, I was in Japan together with a president of NTUC, John DePaver, to attend the Japanese union convention. During the 3 days there, we decided, we saw our face at the convention to give face to the host. But we told the host very frankly, we said that you'd be very helpful for us if you can help to introduce her to some companies, they have been employing older workers in what they call the re-employment concept. So we spent the 3 days visiting companies, talk to the union, talk to the employer, and we were very convinced that re-employment is the way to go. So we brought the concept of re-employment to Singapore. And as a result, we were able to raise the re-employment from 62 to 65, and as PM mentioned, by 2017 to 67. And because of this re-employment, many mature workers, in fact more than 90%, were re-employed upon reaching 62, 63, 64, and so on. In the last 5 years, from 2009 to 2014, among Singaporeans older than 60 years old, the number of people in employment went up from 145,000 to 260,000, an increase of 115,000 in 5 years. Is re-employment a good policy? I agree with you. But this time round, Worker Party again proposed that one good way to grow our employment is to help more mature people to come back to work. Good idea, but 5 years too late. Why? Why said it after 5 years too late? Good politics. Employability. For a long time, or rather a long time ago, we didn't have SMT payroll. So when workers go for training, they can claim course fee subsidies, but the employers have to pay for the absentee payroll. What we did was, we said, look, this is not good because many workers, after working for 20 years, they were still not being upgraded from unskilled workers to become skilled workers. So NTUC came up with this idea called skill redevelopment. Retrain all these low-skilled workers, send them for skill certification, so that when they leave the company, they have a certificate, a skill certificate to go with them. So we send all these older people for retraining, and we supported them with absentee payroll. Then after that, we went to visit them. So I remember I talked to a group of trainees. I said, how is the training? They say, very tiring. I say, why so tiring? He said, all the textbook, the words are too small. Yeah. Then I talked to the course provider. I said, hey, these are uncle auntie. Can you enlarge your font or not? Yeah. Then I went to a course for our Electronic Union workers. Some of them be working in this electronic union factories for many years. So they went for training, so I thought it would be very easy for them. Again, I went to ask them, I said, how is things? They said, very difficult. I said, why? He said, here, they ask us to do integration, differentiation. Yeah. So I said, oh, you never, he said, never, in the factory, we don't do that. In the factory, we deal with a capacitor resistor. We can read the instruction. We know what's the N gate, NOR gate, NAND gate, NAND gate lah. But differentiation, integration, level Q lah, you know. Yeah. So, but my point to you here is this: is that the PAP government, together with tripartite partners, we keep changing. When we realize there's a need to change, we change. And today, training is a norm. Skill certification is a norm through WSQ. Cost subsidy is a norm. Right, so therefore, if you want our employment system to get better and better, to keep changing, who do you vote? Dear fellow Singaporeans, I think to take good and better care of our people, we have no choice but to keep changing, because the world never stops changing, so we have no choice but to keep changing. But from those illustrations I share with you, I think you agree with me that it's easy to make changes, but very difficult to make the good changes, the right changes. And how to do this year after year, decade after decade, keep thinking of good ideas, right ideas, to keep changing for the better. It's not easy, you know. So what keeps us going? What keeps this PAP government going? It's because the driving force for all the change did not just come from our head. Have to think about water problem, training problem, and so on. But actually, the driving force came from our hearts because we care. We care for the workers of Singapore. We care for the people of Singapore. We've come this far in 50 years. We must now create a better SG50 for our children, our grandchildren. Along the way, we have to overcome many more challenges. Some of these challenges is completely new to us. We've never come across them in the last 50 years. For example, our Singaporean workforce one day will stop growing in the near future. Our Singaporean population one day will stop growing in the near future. And one day will become one of the most aged, if not among the most aged in the world, again in the not too distant future. If we focus on right policy, good policy, I believe we can get it right. We can keep growing our economy so that Singapore can remain Singapore unlimited. Better jobs, better career for our people. At the same time, if we focus on good policy, we can make sure that our society, our community, our people will remain Singapore united. In fact, this is the reason why I'm so thankful that I'm a Singaporean, because Singapore indeed is a Singapore unlimited economy and Singapore united people. But if we evolve towards playing politics in Singapore, the whole parliament, like what I said earlier in Mandarin, they're always engaged in politicking, I think we're going to get it very wrong. SG100 is not going to be better than SG50. In fact, if we get it wrong, engage in politics rather than good policy, the cost of living in SG50 will be very low because nobody can afford to buy anything. The standard of living will also be low. In fact, life will be even more stressful than today. You may wonder why. Today we work so hard, we run so fast, life is very stressful. But let me share this with you. The stress of success is a lot less than the stress of failure. I went to France. I talked to the union leaders there. They told me the people who are unemployed, they live a lot more stressful life than those who are working. Yeah. So therefore, don't think that by slowing down will be better. In fact, we are going to have more stress. The government and the parliament elected on September 11, in fact, will have very heavy responsibility. They will change this parliament, this government, to be elected on 11 September. I believe they will change our life over the next 5 years, the next 10 years, the next 15 years. That's for sure. They will change our life. The question is, will they change our life for the better or for worse? I think that is a question you have to ask yourself. You will decide who are the 89 elected MPs in the parliament after September 11, and from which the government, the cabinet, will be formed. And this cabinet, this government, will then lead us, serve us for the next 5 years. My hope is that whichever party, whichever candidates who are voted in, I hope they understand the responsibility that they have to the people of Singapore. I hope that the team to be formed will be a strong team with people with not just strong head, but more importantly, strong heart, who are clean, who are caring, who are competent, who are capable, but most of all, people who are committed to serve our people, our nation, with integrity and honor. I may not have a PhD, or a Oxford brain. But what I have is a Singapore heart. So it's been my privilege to serve our workers and our people for the last 19 years. For me, the interests of people must always be at the heart of everything I do, everything we do. So please support me and my team. Give us a privilege of serving you for another term. Dear voters, we have 50 good years. There are another 50 good years out there waiting for us to create together. Vote PAP! Majulah Singapura!